That ain't right. Yeah. You already know who it is and who it be. It's Greg G, and this is the Greg G Chronicles. And thank you guys for tuning in, showing up, and showing out, you guys. Big shout out to you guys. Big shout out to Meanie, the motherfucking man out there. Yeah. Wow. Let's fucking get it. Hold on. Boys over here. I'm gonna give me a little water right now. Just because, again, I fancy myself a novice sommelier. One of my homies is gonna be on. He's like, dude, I got this Japanese style mixing glass. The homie Kyle, if you guys remember, if you guys watch this, shout out to Kyle. He wants to come back through for another episode, another Fantastico episode, and that's what we're going to do, you know. But before that, I'm going to do a little bit of sipping. I'm going to compare some whiskeys. I think this is a bit much for a little sample. I'm going to put some back, actually. You know what? No, what am I, a fucking pussy? Nah, mama didn't raid no faggot. Fuck. Losing my money is like, yeah, right. You gotta know I don't make money off this shit. I do it for the love of the game. But yeah, let's see. I heard about Kentucky bourbons. You know, I've been fucking with them heavy. This right here, we got, I want to say this one's Evan Williams right here. I heard it's not bad. The cheap one is $15. There's nothing. It just tastes like alcohol. I get what they mean now. I'm starting to figure it out. By caramel, I taste some. I thought I got a hint of caramel, but if you're just going for a bourbon, it's not the bad. It's not the worst. Don't mix it with Coke, dude. I mix it with Coke. It just ruins the bourbon and it ruins the Coke. So now I'm just having to drink more of nasty shit. It's disgusting. But this one's for you guys, Dom Soy. You know, it's funny because I'm watching these two guys. They're doing like 20 different sips of whiskey. And, you know, I'm like, all right, cool. That's what's up. You know me, I'm thinking though, like, all right, damn, you guys are going to knock back 20 shots apiece? I was like, phew, you guys are going to be fucked up. No, they're just sipping it. You know what I mean? They're just sipping on it. Going and then spitting it in a cup. I'm like, yo, you guys aren't at least gonna like drink the mixture, because it had like 20 different bourbons and whiskeys and scotches or whatever in a cup. So I'm like, yo, you guys gotta both split that cup and chug it, bro. What are you guys doing? I forgot what their name was. Very good podcast though, very interesting if you're a bourbon man. Shout out to Meanie if you're a bourbon man. Getting big shout out to that fool, because that fool said he's been listening for a year. And, wow, a whole year. I think the podcast has actually gone downhill, honestly, from a year. I was like, oh, no, the content, dog. But you just got to keep filming, I guess. Fuck it. This right here is the old Jim Beam. First Kentucky bourbon, I think it said. Or whatever the fuck. It's number one in something. This one's the most sold Kentucky bourbon. Number one best-selling Kentucky bourbon. Not because it's the best tasting. But definitely just a cheap one to mix with the Coke. And it still sucks. I'd prefer to just drink it on the rocks, dude. You know what's funny is I thought I liked this one better, but I think I might like this one because this one does have a classic bourbon taste to it. Let me see. I taste the oaks. I taste the thousand-year pines. I taste... When I drink this, I'm standing on top of a mountaintop of drunks. Yeah, you know, but... definitely, I think this one goes down smooth. It doesn't have, like, a crazy pepper burn to it. Or that spice. I guess they'd call it peat. I'm trying to figure that shit out, too. But this one just goes down like alcohol and just goes. Like, it's not bad. It's not good. It's just there. This one does have a bit more flavor. What the motherfucker? Has more depth. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, yes. Very, very sophisticated and delectable and delicious. Yes, yes, yes. All right, let's shoot this one. Dom soy. I'm going to go with this one. But because I'm going to go with this one, that means I'm going to drink this one. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on now. What do I got to do?
Try them together right now over me.
All right, let's see this right here. A splash of the mahogany and a splash of the ambrosia. Oh, Lord, I'm going to get drunk on this podcast. Fuck. This next drink, I'm going to have to sip. I'm going to have to sip it responsibly. Sip it very smooth, very clean. All right, let's see. Let me give it a good little swirlies. And, you know, let me get some water real quick to cleanse the palate. These fucking guys. I've been talking about this for a minute, but I know I'm being redundant, repeating myself and everything. But that's just how much I'm getting into this whole whiskey bourbon shit, dog. It's fucking crazy. Mm. It's almost as crazy as my infatuation with Temu. I've been loving Temu. I already got commercials lined up regarding Temus and Emus. You know, they got Limu Emu. Why not Temu Emu? Where's the Temu Emu? It's just a Japanese ostrich with sharp glasses instead of round, cool cop ones. Or Temu the panda. I don't know. They need a mascot is what I'm saying. I think they do got a mascot. But yeah, damn it, Temu, you've been getting me. I wasn't even drunk and I spent fucking 90 bucks, 60 bucks. And I was like, no, I thought I was going to get it for free. They rushed me. I was under duress. Bah. I was like, I need to call my team. I need to call my fucking Jews. I need to call my cousins, the Mexi-Jews, and have them do a class action lawsuit on these fucking guys. But I returned the cheapest thing. But anyway, hold on. You know what? Let's get back to the bourbon. We'll get to Temu later. Let's try the mixers, you guys. All righty. One more. Goddamn. 3 Dom Sois within the first 7 minutes. Damn, it's already been 7 minutes. Holy crap. All right. Dom Soy. Not bad. I definitely still taste this over that in there. The flavor of the Jim Beam. I'll just let you know how strong that Jim Beam is compared to the flavor. Oh. All right. Anyways, though. Yeah, wow. Interesting mix. I'm going to be drunk as shit. One's 40%. The other one's 43%. Oh, fucking... whatever. But it's that 3% that might get me. Like 4th of July when I drank too much of that 60% shine. Allegedly, I was drinking moonshine. Got to say allegedly because one of my boys was like, oh. Allegedly, you can't be rolling around with moonshine nowadays like that. Or else you're going to get 10 years. Or you can't even be drinking it. And I was like, what happens if I drink it on film? He's like, well, you better put it in a different bottle and call it something else. So allegedly. It's all alleged. But yeah, that shit got me all fucked up. Quick, too. Not even quick. I was just fucked up the whole night constantly. And I pretty much drank the whole bottle. I gave like a couple shots away, but I drank the whole mason jar, a whole one of these pretty much, and some more. I was like, oh man, that was stupid of me. Still went to work though, like a savage. Woke up drunk. But you know, once you shower, you're good to go. Allegedly. But, which that was fun. But yeah, so Temu's just been hitting me, dog. I play the games. I'm just sitting there on my phone. My wife's like, hey, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm on Temu. I'm on the Temu. Just doing my thing, shopping. I'm buying useless shit or wanting to buy useless shit, putting it in my cart. I'm putting it there, then taking it back out. Like, no, I don't need this in my cart. What the hell? But like I said, I spent 60 bucks. On Temu, thinking I was going to get shit for free. No, I was still like 30. I needed to spend like 90 bucks to get shit for free. And ain't no way at that time I wanted to spend now $90. I was like, oh, your boy's got to make it to the fucking next check. You know, I'm on that paycheck to paycheck, dog. But, you know, paying all the bills, son. But I end up hitting the buy button. And I was sitting in my car stone cold sober. Maybe if I was drunk, I would have been like, don't do it, Greg. You're drunk. Don't do it, motherfucker. Don't do it. But since I was sober, I was like, yeah, I'm in my right mind and faculties, mind, body, and sound. So I hit the buy button. And it's like, all right, you just spent $62.83 at Temu. And I was like, oh. I was telling my wife, I was like, fuck, babe. Thankfully, I was good still, but I was like, babe, fuck. I spent $60 on Temu. I wasn't supposed to do that. That's mighty irresponsible. I could have bought something else, you know. I could have bought another bottle. Ah, two bottles. Ah, gas. Ah, Hot Pockets. Oh, my God. All right, $60 is like hella Hot Pockets. It's a game. Damn, dude, I could have bought Madden 24 by its 25 by itself, or I could have been halfway there to buying the NCAA Madden bundle pack. Oh, but diapers, dog, fuck. My ass, though, I go to Temu. I freaking Google how to get. All right, you know what? I lied. I ChatGPT that shit. All right, I fuck with ChatGPT. I got an episode talking mad shit on it, but I don't use it for nothing, like, to figure shit out. I just ask it questions like, hey, if I get this for monthly dividends, how many stocks do I gotta buy of it? You know what I mean? How much? How do you calculate alcohol by volume? Any dumb question I can think of that I happen to just come across, I'll ask ChatGPT sometimes. So it's all right. It's not too bad. I made a mistake. It's okay.
Move this man. Move.
I know. But they teach me how to do it. Hell, actually, I YouTube it too. But still, either way, though. And what do I do, dude? Instead of, like, returning a screen projector that was, like, $30, it can cast an 80-inch screen, I return a $2 kitchen strip that keeps shit from falling inside the cracks of your kitchen. Like, if your refrigerator's next to your stove countertop and there's that little crack, that spacing, you slide that in there and it keeps shit from falling in. And I was like, dude, that's fucking genius. My wife would love all these things. Got her some fruit slicers. I was like, yes. If I'm going to buy anything, it's for my wife to cook for me. Because technically, it's for me. What a man. Yeah, it's still for me, you know. But, and what stupid women gifts thoughts I was thinking of. Like, yes, women belong in the kitchen, which they do. So buy my wife kitchen stuff. Cutleries, if you will, the finest cuisine Cutco knives. And all the time, though, I mean, like, I'm thinking, dude, there's got to be uranium in this shit. There's got to be some goddamn, what's that shit that's killing everybody? Fentanyl. There's got to be some sort of illicit substance in these things. Because, you know, the Chinese, they're trying to kill us. Not only have they been, they've already been going pee-pee in our coke for centuries.
Mel Gibson, not too shabby.
All right. It wasn't too shabby of a joke, but that's just a stupid classic joke, you know. But I'm tired of them playing jokes on us, damn it. So, yeah, I was buying my wife woman stuff. She loved it, though. She loved her little choppy, choppy slicers. She gave me a little choppy, choppy on my slicer, on my slizzer, you know. And, yeah. It's been fun making fun of her, talking about her love and infatuation with anal sex. My wife just loves it. She can't get enough of anal sex, dude. She's like, pound me right in my sweet fucking butt sniz. I was like, oh, you want it in the butt sniz, you dirty birdie? Oh, oh, BBW loves anal, huh? But, nah, she doesn't. But I just love saying it, especially to her mother, to my mother-in-law. And she's just like, like a angry Asian tiger mom agreeing with the father about why they're beating the son and shit. Yes. Sorry to the Asian folks. Shout out, mad love for the Asian culture. my chinkas. Anyways, though, to all my beanas, what up? I feel like I gotta say every slur now, but no, fuck that. But yeah, Temu's been awesome. Other than that, though, I've just been just seeing shit, dude. I saw an Indian fool with the hardest nipples I've ever seen in my life. I was like, damn, dude. How do your nipples get like that? You know what I mean? You got to tape those bad boys down. Now, if your wife's nipples were like that at the store, the Indian chick, the Indian wife, sister, could be a sister. Who knows? Could be a stepsister. Oh, watch out. Yeah, anyways, though, her nipples ain't that hard, but his nipples are just dangerously hard. It's disgusting, dude. I couldn't stop looking at them. I was like, fuck, dude. And he had that hard fat, you know, like, where, like, it just sits there hard, you know? He had the side titties kind of, I'm working up, you know what I mean? But they were just sitting there. He was wearing gray, and gray just accentuates everything, you know? Tiny dicks to hard nips, bro. The gray will show it all, dude. Fucking A. Sweat stains. Oh, God. Gray is a terrible color. But I was getting lost upon staring at the tips of his Matterhorns. Nipples. Pause. No, Diddy. Whatever. All that and nothing, right? But it got to me. It just made me think, what race of men have the hardest nipples? Is it Mexicans, Asians, black folks, American black folks versus African black folks? Is it all age? Are these Indian fools out there in the game just rocking these hard nips? Khabib Nurmagomedov, I think he has hard nipples. If you ask him, he'd be like, no, I do not have hard nipples. That's gay. No, no, no. No hard nipples, my friend. You know? But yeah, it's just like, dude, come on. How can you be? You got to feel how hard your nipples are at that point. You know what I mean? It's like when you're, I'll drop it. You know what I mean? Let me see this shit. All right. You know what? I'm thinking about slamming this shit, but. All righty. Other than that, though, man, and then using stoner logic. Because I don't get high as much anymore. I'm thinking about getting back to it, obviously, all the time. Maybe when my wife gets a job, then I can have that extra income back again. And we could be fucking balling again. Ah, two incomes, dude. Hey, where the fuck? Fuck it. Oh, well. There we go. That's where it was. But I was just high. Thinking and reminiscing, and I was like, damn, dude. When I was a kid in Merced, Atwater, shout out 209, it'd be hot as shit. And the stoner logic comes through like, fuck, we just need to get high, boys. If we can just get high, we will be all right, you know? And that's what we did. We just figured out how to get some buds so we could cool the fuck down. Not chill in the AC house, because it was still hot, I don't know, you know? So we were like, all right, cool. We got a 10 sack or a dub, maybe an eighth if we got them, as my cousin would say, an eighthums. But shit, man, you fuck, even as a 13, 14-year-old, just knowing that, fuck, dude, it's hot. But if we smoke, we'll be okay. Because, you know, stoner logic, oh, if you just get high, it'll get cooler. And it's like, isn't that some high shit? Like, you get high to where you think it to where it gets colder? No, fool. It doesn't work like that. It's still 101 degrees. You just don't give a shit. You know, you're just like, now I'm just fucking high. Now you're high and hot, but you're so high, you don't give a fuck about being hot because you're like 13, 14, a little dumb, goofy-ass kid. A goofy-ass kid, dude. And just be like, oh, it's hella cold, dude. Cold thoughts, man. Fuck. And we didn't talk like that. Maybe we did. I don't know. I don't remember. But I just always like to think about it because I'll see, like, young kids that are, like, probably 13, 14. I'm like, damn, you guys are fucking goofy. But I'm sure I was that goofy. The only thing is I was smoking weed, dude. That's a crazy combination. And Yeah, I would do nothing better than being 13 and watching stand-up comedy in your room, 13, 14, and you're just high, like a dork who watches stand-up comedy at 13, 14. I don't know, you know, but there I am watching like Bobby Kelly or Louis C.K. somebody, and I'm just like trying to hold in my soda because I snuck out to, not snuck out, I walked out to the kitchen to get a drink or something. I'm like, breaking a rib because I'm not trying to laugh that loud, because if I laugh that loud, I'm my cover's blown. Now my mom's going to know I'm high. She's going to kick the shit out of me. She'll be relentless at 13. Come on now, you know, but yeah. But yeah, damn, that's pretty fun. Real quick, too, I don't know if you guys have seen that video of the black chick holding a gun, riding in the back of an Uber. I was like, damn, dude, that's bad. I've been watching those black Republican twins. They're big MAGAs, and they're like, them's my MAGAs. And my MAGA, what a motherfucker. We just like, you know what, I was down with Trump back in the day. Again, y'all know I got forced to not like him and shit, but I fuck with him. But yeah, is that the new greeting now? My MAGA, what's up? Slap me some skin, play up my MAGA. But this bitch pulls out like a Glock or a Beretta. It was a 9. Actually, it was just a 9. And she's just fucking around with it, going like this to the back of the driver. The driver's like, and where are you ladies from? You know, and they're just like, and all I was thinking was like, dude, please do not let that gun go off, dude. Please don't let that shit happen. You know what I mean? I get it. Cameramen die from that shit because the rappers, the rappity rappers are like, yo, yo, boom, boom, plow, ah! But I was like, please don't let this motherfucker get shot in the back. And then speaking of, I've been watching people get fucking blasted, apparently, and I was like, oh no, because at first, there's another video of two cops in a black chick's house, old black woman, and the cops are like, all right, you know, get what you need to get or get turn off the stove. And all of a sudden, though, the chick has the hot water, and I guess she dumps it. I don't know. She dumps it, but and she has hot water. The cops say, hey, yo, ma'am, get rid of that pot of water. And I guess she does. I don't know. My wife said she did because she had me rewatch it. I guess she did. I don't know. But cop straight up blasted her ass, dude. Just blah, blah. And I thought that was kind of fucked up, honestly. I was like, damn, dude. At first, I just watched it being stupid. Like, just like, oh, shit. Bitch got shot. Doesn't matter. Any type of bitch. Just a bitch got shot. I was like, god damn. You know? But then my wife started breaking it down hella. Gave me shit I didn't even know about. She's like, well, did you know the guy had a racist tattoo? A white supremacist tattoo? And I was like, she said, a skull on fire. I was like, I don't know. That's pretty standard, but okay. Okay. Don't know the skull. Don't know what it is. It could have been, you know. There's guys on both sides. Both sides. Good guys, bad guys on both sides. But I was like, god damn, you know. So we rewatched it, and I was like, yeah, you know what? It looked like she did kind of drop the water in the sink. But who the fuck, don't fuck around with the cops. Don't say nothing about I rebuke you, because the cop was like, I'll shoot you in the face. I'll shoot you in the fucking face. The cop said, I'll shoot your ass, bitch. I'll come and, bitch, throw that fucking water. Oh, fucking blah, blah. You know what I mean? And he was fucking around and find out. He was about his shit. You know, and I have a family member that's a cop, you know. A estranged family member? I don't know, but he's cool. He's all right. He calls me a jabroni, but he's a jabroni. We're jabronis. But anyways, though, this motherfucker was like, I'll shoot you in your face. And she's like, I rebuke you. And then she was at the sink, and I don't know if she already poured the water up, but she lifted up the pot. Now, I don't know if she was lifting up the pot to show the cops or what, but that cop just straight up went, boom, boom, blasted her ass. headshots, dude, to the dome. She was done. She died on it. Died in an instant. I've seen action movies. I've seen the goddamn televisions. You know what I mean? The películas. I've seen this. That shit's done. Done, son. But my wife, being the one who's related to the cop, she's like, no, you don't do that. And it's her dad. So anyways, her dad would tell her, like, no, why would you do that? If you're going to be a cop, you're there to get shot. You know what I mean? You're not there to shoot up motherfuckers just out of nowhere. You know, I like to say he's a dirty cop, but he's not. He's cool. He's the man. Shout out Mr. Father-in-law. But yeah, my wife, fucking told me, why didn't they pull out the taser? Why do they go straight for their gun? Why didn't they get the taser out? You know, you could have gave her a fucking judo chop, a fucking wham, you know, a quick something. And then she was like, what, you're just going to get second degree burns? I was like, that shit might melt your skin off. You might be a naked chicken by the time that water touches your ass. You don't know how hot boiling water is. The shit's boiling. Did you not know this? It's over 190 degrees Fahrenheit. That's like 32 degrees Celsius, I believe. Give or take. Fuck Celsius. It's all about Fahrenheit, baby. Inches, miles. Fuck this kilometer Jingo Django. Give me none of this bloody Jingo Django. And, yeah, so we were just having a debate. Wow, that's crazy, dude. 7 minutes flies, but took a minute to get to here. But, I gotta stop watching the clock and just ball out. But, it was just a debate. And I was like, damn, fool, don't make me feel like that fucking... Don't make me feel like no racist. I just looked at it like a glance. But once you break it down, you kind of see more shit. Watch it a couple times, and I was like, eesh. I don't know if I could protect all Blue Lives Matter on this one, you know what I mean? I was like, this Black Life mattered, I guess, more than that fucking blue. I was like, eesh. But yeah, that bitch got shot hella bad. Hella bad. I was like, whoo, fuck. I don't make no jokes around no cops. I just say, yes, sir, no, sir, okay, sir, I'm putting up my hands on the wheel just to let you know. Already, sir, I'm reaching for my glove compartment box. No weapons. All right. Sir, may I pull my phone out real quick so I can get my insurance number? It's on my phone, sir. Do you mind? It's just right here. Yep. All righty. Open. Boom. I'm fucking proper. The highest class. The king's English. The queen's English. Oh, yes, constable. I shall retrieve my paperwork. Yes, indeed. I shall. I will. Oh, good day. Cheerio, you know? Ain't no way I'm gonna let no fucking buster ass cop roll up on me and kill me because I'm acting like a buffoon, like an imbecile. You know what I mean? It's just too much. Fuck. Again, shout out to my primo, but that's fucking funny. When he tried to attempt his own, he tried to unalive himself. Sorry, just the thought of using that phrase is fucking funny. But anyways, though, the old popo show up. They cut him down, you know, and he rolls, falls, and whatever, right? Gotta say this, my cousin is still like, boo, he's faking, he's a fucking faker. He ain't fucking passed out, no one snores, he's faking. I was like, what the fuck? You know what I mean? But this is what I had to say.
Yeah, I'm a little lit, so what?
Cause we were all fucked up. I was drunk. We were drunk. I was pretty. I was buzzing. I want to say, or at least high. I was lit. I was something. Ain't no way I was sober. Like that's a good thing. But yeah, no. Ain't no way I was sober. A couple, like when I was 22, 21. Now, like shit changed. What the fuck? Fuck. What was the point of it though? Oh yeah. But when he gets up, he's like, "Don't shoot me." Don't shoot me! Like, oh, fuck, why the fuck is he yelling this out? But at that point, though, this was the heat, the hype of cops just picking off minorities, like, bam, like, they're picking them off like pimples, like blackheads. Oh, whoa, no pun intended, god damn it. But they were popping them like blackheads, dude. I was like, god damn, putting the squeeze on them, see? Man, I put the squeeze on you, see? And, Yeah, that shit was some shit. But his dad didn't get shot. He was cool. He was doing damn good. Oh, I don't know. He was doing all right. But, yeah, that would have been fucking crazy if my cousin got shot by the goddamn cops. Dude, fuck. They would have fucking had to empty a clip on him. He's a big boy. You know what I mean? Again, he almost outpowered him. It was pretty cool. He almost fucking got their motherfucking asses, dog. I was like, holy shit. He Hulkamaniaed up on the cops. He was going, dun, 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 dun. I was like, oh my God, he's going to fucking do it. I was like, oh my God. He was rising up like a phoenix. You ever see a 400-pound man rise out of his overalls like a phoenix in the sun? I was like, God damn, dude. It was incredible. It was a feat, dude. It was a sight. I wish JR was there. JR would have been like, oh my God, King, we got a hell of a fight. He's going to overpower them. Oh my God. It was insane, bro. But all we needed was like Rollo or Riley to throw a fucking chair in the mix. But damn, that was fucking amazing. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That leads me, though, I guess, to guns and all of this violence and prosecution to a new prosecutor coming out there in the world. The heaviest, hiddenest, most fucking arresting your ass motherfucker in the game. Kamala, if you haven't been there to be in the past to get to where you need to go today now, Harris, look under your chairs. But yeah, Kamala Harris is in the game right now. I've been hearing a lot of shit about them scheming, planning, and conniving. In the words of Cat Williams, you got to keep trying shit and trying shit, trying shit and trying shit. And yeah, apparently, though, Kamala Harris, they were sneakily trying to get her in there. And they were waiting till the primary chances were done, which is why they kept Biden around and then took his ass out to sneak her ass in as a new nominee. Bitch raised $250 million, $220 million probably by now, maybe 300 now, who knows? But it's like, goddamn, it's funny how cute they think that you raised money like that, Kamala. No, you're big banksters. All your guys put that money in, and then you also got the money from Biden's shit. You know what I mean? So it's like, yo, you didn't do jack shit. No one knows you. No one knows your ass. You just dance like a fucking slut. I'm just gonna say it. Not no race, no nothing. I don't know what the fuck she's done. You know, the bitch was live. Called her the border shark. You know what I mean? What's that movie called? El Demono Negro, Negra. They called it the Black Demon or something. It was a fucking shark movie. Because you know my love for shark movies, you guys. I love them all. Oh, my daughter's awake. Son of a bitch. But anyways, though. Yeah, she was supposed to be tough on borders. Like, no, you weren't. You didn't do much. I mean, I think Obama did more. Obama was deporting motherfuckers left and right. You know what I mean? We had to remove people that should not be here for today. Because this makes a better tomorrow. So, yes. And then maybe we can all have more jobs. But that shit's crazy, though. I mean, I don't know what Kamala's going to do. I just saw her dancing and shit. I don't know her policies, though. I'm willing to listen, I guess. But I don't know. You know, I can't count her out. If in boxing and UFC, you know, there's opponents in fighting, you can't underestimate your opponent no matter what, you know. And all I know is about Kamala Harris is I watched a 4-minute video. I watched 2 minutes of a 4-minute video of her just, the unburdening must be unburdened from yesterday's burdening. And I was like, the unburdening must be unburdened from yesterday's burdening that brings us a burden today? What the fuck? It's like, dude, why are you speaking in these riddles, these tongues, these freaking riddles? Why do I have to solve a clue? He reminds me of the jewelry cat. I think that the Indian fool who always sells jewelry to like what's his name? Pure Cocaine. He sings that song, Lil Baby. Lil Baby. Like, he's like, okay, what is a thing that gets wetter as it dries? A towel. Make these quarters into two straight lines with one dime. I was like, what the fuck? Two straight lines and one dime? What the fuck? There's no dime. But it's just some crazy nonsensical shit. But, hey, I'm going to let it be. I mean, y'all already know I'm going T-Dog on this one. And every time I say T-Dog, it just makes me think of waiting. Because there's this guy, he's, what is he called? James! Theodore! Help me out! We need to put this fire out now! It's Champ from fucking Anchorman, but he's the restaurant manager. I'll put a, if I remember, if I listen to this, I'll put a goddamn thing to see. But it just makes me think that Trump is T-Dog when I call him T-Dog, and he's like, yo, man, I told you stop calling me motherfucking Theodore. And he's pouring gasoline. It's T-Dog. So, yeah, I was just like, damn, dude, that shit's fucking funny. Just T-Dog, old T-Dog over there, old dick slapper. Motherfuckers walks in and starts slapping dicks. What up, you fucking pussy? Get out of here. That'd be fucking dope, dude. Trump's just a bros, bro, just flicking motherfuckers on the cock. Flick. I flicked your head, bitch. What are you going to do? Why the fuck does that sound like more like Ronald Reagan and shit? How you doing, partner? What the fuck? I said I'm gonna kick him in his penis. I kicked him in the penis. I said, wow, that's my foot. But damn, dude. So it's gonna be fun to watch him debate. Kamala's gonna be like, and that's why I think I should be the presidential nominee, because, and then Trump just walked in. Or just black, just fucking says some stupid shit. She's a woman. Don't trust her. Just says some stupid shit like that. Like, fuck. He ain't gonna. But trust me, though. It's gonna be amazing. This debate coming up is gonna be a great one. And I'm intrigued. I'm all ears. I'm intrigued to see. I'm gonna get a buck. Oh, lordy lord. Almost Ralphed it on there. Call me Ralph, dog. But I'm going to get a bottle, not of this shit. I'm going to get the good shit. You know what I mean? A political debate to be seen only deserves the finest of maybe even Woodford, Bullet Bourbon. I don't know. You know, maybe I'll get allegedly some of the shine, you know, allegedly. I don't know where to get it, though. It just drops down on my lap. God just bestows it upon me. Whoop! And it's there, you know? Damn, I wish I had some on me so I could just snap my fingers and it just pops up, but I don't. Oh, well, it is what it is, right? Anyways, though. Man, I hear my damn daughter being a fucking bitch up there. I won't say that to her face. Obviously not, because I love her, but still, it's just like, damn. But yeah. Guys, that's been pretty... Oh, shit, France. That's right, I forgot to talk about France, dude. So France has been on one. We're going to make fun of these stupid Christians. We're going to give them croissants, the Christian croissants, and we're going to call them faggots. Baggots for faggots. They love the breasts. Jesus skin, fucking matter penis. Why did I go Asian? I don't fucking know. Jesus Christ. Holy shit. What the fuck? Anyways, though, those stinky French were making fun of my boy Jesus. They're making fun of Leonardo da Vinci, dog. And you know what? I don't know about Leonardo da Vinci. He was an artist. You know what I mean? He painted The Last Supper, I guess. But I don't know. He's an artiste. I don't know if he was sucking, chugging cum. You know what I mean? He was an old cum chuggler. He was an old pickle smoker. The old skin flute player. You know what I mean? They're all artistes. You know? I don't know. You know? Oh. I'm tired of this. I bore of this bourbon. Give me something better. Anyways, though. Nail polish. I get hints of nail polish. God damn. When they cut this, this is how they cut their cocaine with this shit. But yeah, I've been watching the news. Because I saw some shit and motherfuckers were on X, on the old X-Files. And people were like, I'm boycotting the Olympics. I ain't never going to watch the Olympics. Fuck the Olympics. And I was like, Jesus Christ, what'd they do? You know? And my first thought was like, damn, dude, they put some tranny shit up there. No offense to the T's, you know, the LGBTs and the Q's. It is what it is, you know? Y'all are still minorities, so you got to get fucked with the bit. I ain't going to lie. Just roll with the punches, be cool, laugh at it, take go with it, you know what I mean? Hey, straight guys don't get no parade, so hey, I ain't tripping, you know what I mean? But I was like, fuck, it's got to be some shit like that, dude. Why the fuck else is anyone trying to trip over this shit? But I guess it kind of was that, okay? There's cool people that'll happen to be that. I know there's also, like, people that are on the sex offender registration list and shit, so it's... There's good and bad on both sides. Both sides, good and bad, good and bad. But, I mean, they say they're gay. They have the dicks. I walked in. I said, wow, she has a dick. Blonde hair, very nice. But, but this fucking, yeah, I don't know. The French be tripping. They had a lady dressed up in baguettes and croissants. Some people were like, damn, they shit on their own country somehow. But they also shit on the Christian faith. Even one lady said they shit on the Jews. I was like, oh, hell no. They're going to get all their sponsors cut. They're going to take, hey, I say, we got to take the cameras away. You bring the cameras, and we got the cameras. They're Lewitskit's cameras. We need the cameras back. You know what I mean? We got to fight Hamas. We have to film the Hamas tragedies, the horrific things. We can't do the Olympics, so give them back now. That's some shit, dude. Can you imagine Jewish folks just confiscating fucking Olympic cameras? They're like, hey, hey, Vey, give me the 345 film lens. Go ahead, do it now. I say. It's fucking stupid. But how are you going to run with no track? My cousin's built the tracks. My cousin owns the companies that builds the high as the penis to build the tracks. The high as the Chinese. The high as the Japs. The high as... High as the blacks, the Sudis, you know, I was like, dang, the sticky finger bandits over here and shit. But yeah, apparently they offended Christians. Some lady said Jewish people because I guess, you know, I don't know, Jesus Christ is Jewish. I don't know, you know. But what you, if we're not going to get into all of that. But yeah, I thought it was just some freaky deaky shit. You know what I mean? I thought they had, my wife said, oh, they had a chick with the beard. You know, they had a dude. And I was like, okay, the carny shit, that's been a thing since forever. I don't know if carnies originate from France. Maybe they did. So I was like, oh, that ain't that big of a deal. But once I found out, oh, they shit on my shit. And, you know, I don't go to church, though, but I believe in God. I pray every morning. Or, you know, some days I take off, you know, but every morning I pray for everybody and stuff like that, right? But my wife was like, why? Who cares? Is it affecting you personally? And I was just like, yes, it is. Right now, I'm angry. I'm distraught. I am in distress. Pimp in distress right now because they made fun of my boy. But really, I was like, I don't know, dude. It doesn't affect me in any way. I mean, the only thing is that I'm upset about is that France is all about not trying to offend, free fuck, free love, all of that shit. It's fucking lick the inside of your dirty, fucking disgusting foreskin. And I'm uncircumcised, y'all, but still, like, I'm American, so I keep my shit clean. But them French are disgusting and dirty. You know what I mean? You already know I got a video talking shit on them because they think they're better because they got McDonald's and shit that makes better food. Wait till we start fucking up your laws, bitch. Wait till we start fucking tying down your goddamn corporations, motherfucker, or your government to give it to, so you guys can get the McClone combos also. Don't give me that. Come on. You bust this. Ooh, two Bismarcky references, two episodes back to back. God damn it. I wanted to, oh yeah, I guess it's, nah, it's Meek Mill's, me and Dana going back to bed. But Meek Mill's, I guess, got clapped in his ass. Drake's in some hot water, and I'm a West Coast guy, so fuck that. But still, god damn it, that was a good song. Anyways, though. Yeah, I guess they had a bitch by the hair of her chinny chin chin sitting in the middle being like Jesus. I don't know. There was this big bitch with big old titties. That was cool. I don't know if it was a guy, though, but I was like, those tits are too big and nice. Even though, you know, I was like, damn. me gusta los chichis grandes, you know what I mean? Those weren't grande tits, those were venti titties. Them titties were ventis, dog. Those are some big titties. I was like, God damn. If that would have been a guy, I would have been like, holy shit, dude, whoever sculpted your titties used only the finest fats from your ass to make those, you know? Like, God damn, those are big titties. But, yeah, I don't know. I get it. I understand, dude. I like hearing British people being like, I was suddenly appalled to see what I saw. So much so, I turned off the television, went to my room, and had anal sex with my husband. I was like, Jesus Christ, lady, you too? First my wife and now you? Shit. You know, but I don't know, dude. It's just like, I care, but I don't care. You know, I mean, okay, the only thing I care about is like, why do you got to bring it to the Olympics? You know, why? Plus, a lot of Olympic players or sportsmen always say, yo, I'd like to thank God, Jesus Christ, or I'd like to thank God. My friends, I'd like to thank God. Obviously, I'd like to thank Jehovah or Abraham. But I don't know the Jesus fellow, but he was a good fellow. I recognize that he was a poison, but still, you know. yeah, shit, dude. Hell, I think, North Koreans and shit, I don't know if they're even in this Olympics. Oh, that reminds me, speaking of Koreans, they fucked up too. They labeled where North Korea is as South Korea and where South Korea is as North Korea. I was like, yo, how do you fuck this up, dog? How do you fuck that up? North up top, South down at the bottom. Two totally different geographical locations. How do you fuck that up? Where is the quality control? Where's QC? Where's QC the label at for this bitch? God damn it, amigos. They should have had Offset and Quavo on there, RIP Takeoff, you know what I mean? Mama. But I just thought that shit was insane. What the hell? And again, they don't need to be preaching or teaching that shit. I don't want to have to explain to my kids what the fuck this shit is on the Olympics. Come on now. Let me explain it to them in a different way out in the world when we're walking and they see a hot, sexy he-she with the fucking 5 o'clock shadow that'll make any man's cock hard. You know what I mean? Let me be out there in the real world where I can be like, yo, dude, there's just some people out there that are different. You know what I mean? Hey, don't be rude. Don't treat them any different. But just know that shit's out there and it's weird to some. It's weird to me. If you can't see, then the blind eyes of a million pairs can't stop and stare. You know what I mean? Sorry, I tried to throw in a Tupac reference. And I tried to channel my inner Kamala Harris. But, anyways, though. Yeah, that's just crazy, dog. I'm getting drunk, so. Dumb, soy! So, yeah, I just thought that shit was funny. I mean, it's sports, dog. God, track and field, and discus, motherfucker, and wrestling. Come on, now. What the fuck? Just keep it simple, stupid. Give us the fucking fireworks, the national anthems. Give us the shit that we need to see that it shows your country, shows our country, shows a little bit of the flavors of the world to show some love, you know what I mean? Get over here, you Marquez Trickett. Show me some love. And that's it. You know, but somehow they fucked it up and everyone is mad again. They're supposed to be the fucking peaceful world of progressivism and shit, progressivism, but they just fucked up, because again, Justin Trudeau, he'll be talking, you know, we have to be there for they, and them, and those, and us, and we, and she, and he, and, you know, he uses all the right pronouns, he tries to keep his speeches cool, tries to not be offensive to anybody. But you want to walk around and then just fucking fuck with Christians Day, in the words of fuck with Dre Day, dog. What the fuck? You know, it is what it is, I guess. But I won't take this laying down or on my knees. I will stand up next to you and defend her still today. For at least I'm proud I love this land. God bless the USA. USA was founded by Jesus Christ. I hope you know that. Only Jesus Christ himself, put his spirit into Christopher Columbus to use them as a puppet, as a conduit, if you will, to find this great God-blessed country. All right, I'm going too far, too stupid with this shit. It doesn't matter, though. None of you motherfuckers make it this far anyways. Maybe Mimi's, maybe you do. Shout out to Meanie. Meanie's, what the fuck? Meanie, shout out to you if you do. But anyways, though, fuck France. Fuck the French as a fucking label, record crew, and as a staff. Homie, we hit them up. America, better win. Don't know if they have or haven't, because I haven't watched this shit. Because I haven't cared or given enough time for it. I probably should, though. I should check out the fucking wrestling. Skeet shooting, because you know me. I did a couple skeet shots not too long ago. but yeah, dude. What else? What's a good fun sport? Swimming. Women's volleyball. You got to check out women's volleyball. You must. It's a must. Ooh, speaking of, Kevin Durant put on an amazing performance. Motherfucker was dropping buckets. Had a perfect game, I think, I want to say. Like 21, 25 points. Made all of his shots. He was laying down threes. Dropping fadeaways. Ooh, mean fadeaways. Fell back and slid. Still was going like that. I was like, God damn it. What a savage. You an ugly motherfucker, but God damn it, you could ball. God gave you the ability to ball. Now, if you can ball, then you can stand tall. Sorry, just being stupid. But anyways, yeah, it was pretty cool. It made me feel good. I was like, damn, son. And LeBron, dope as fuck, stoic, did what he needed to do, dropped some shots, I think 13 to 20 points, I forgot what he did, but he had a flawless game. I think he made all his shots, drained some buckets, did some dunks. I was like, God damn it, what a savage fool. LeBron's the man, dude, at 39, I was like, dude, at 39, dude, to be that athletic, that strong, that physically gifted, steroids or not, HGH, fucking TRT, any acronyms you can have for steroids, for dopeliness. It's amazing, honestly. A true feat that will never be matched, especially with the physicality that he would play and the generations that he has played with the old generation of the oldest of the new back then. I don't know, like, fuck, I want to say he came in like 04 maybe? 06-ish probably. But it was amazing, you know. So it was pretty cool to see his ass still charging up the court, dunking on a motherfucker. You know, Nikola Jokic didn't know what the fuck to do. Or Jokic, he was like, God damn it, these Slavic whites can't handle it. They can't handle these ballers, these gracious black ballers. You know what I mean? I'm only one guy. Maybe if I have a team of black folks that aren't as good as me, I can still win, but if when I got a team of white folks, some Slavs, some sloppy Slavs, I ain't gonna be doing so good. I have to carry the team. He couldn't carry the team. It's a lot of weight, you know, a lot of short, dense muscle weight, a lot of hair, you know, they're hairy people. But yeah, it was pretty cool to see. Durant was just fucking hammering them down. It was pretty cool. I was like, dropping them threes for America, motherfucker. I was like, damn, that's good. I was like, I salute you, motherfucker. But all right, you guys, I'm gonna call it though. Again, you know what? Over the first Kentucky bourbon, I want to say, or whatever the fuck they call it, Evan Williams, Elijah Craig, I want to say, is the first person to make a bourbon. And it wasn't bad. I'm gonna get some more when I fucking am not sick, but the Evan Williams wasn't too bad. It's not shit, but it's not it. You know what I mean? This one is getting closer. I would rate this at a 1 out of 10. This is going to get like a 4. This will get like a 4.8. Nah, maybe a 4, because there's worse bourbons. There's worse. You know what I mean? So that's what that'll get. They're mid, very mid, very low mid, you know. Not the worst, though. But, yeah. What the fuck did I pour in here? Hold on. Now I gotta figure it out. How good am I? I forgot what I poured in here. That's the Evan. That's the Evan for sure. 1 million billion. Ain't no Sicilian. Ain't no ham hawking. Ain't no hawk toing. Shout out to the hawk two girl too. Apparently being famous is kind of ruining her life. A lot of perverts are out there being like, yo, come suck my penis. Please, hawk two on my tiny cock. Ugh. So I feel bad for her, you know what I mean? She's getting the good with the bad. All the fucking celebrities are like, yeah, come fuck. Come get this dick because I'm rich, bitch. You know what I mean? But she's still sticking to her southern, Jesusly charm. I'm like, damn, bitch, good for you. You know what I mean? She's still sticking to her. She's letting her be her. But anyways, though, shout out to her. Shout out to you guys. Let's see what the fuck I got right here. Gonna fuck your bitch. Oh no. Alrighty, you guys. Yep, I'm gonna have to call it. The computer's low. You guys already know who it is and who it be. It's Greg G. Thank you guys for tuning in. That's not enough to dom. Soy, god damn it. Come on now. Alright, this is it. Oh, Lord. I'm going to have to be very careful once I'm done. Holy shit. Alright, you guys, you already know the fucking deal. Will and Dylan, killing and chilling. Thank you guys for chilling with me and dealing with me and everything like that. I know. But I really appreciate it. Always very happy for every view that I get. And I don't care if I can't take a shit without someone standing by it. No, yes, I will give you an autograph. Yes, whatever, all that shit that Eminem said no to. But big shots. Big shotgun shells in your ass is bad for your health, but fuck that shit. Take a shot and shut the fuck up. Dom Soy! Peace.